Hello everyone, this video we are talking about Creality mainboard version 4.2.2. Let's see close up. Okay, at the input we have three views. As you can see, the views located at here, here, and the last thing is here. You can see this big 5 times views for stepper motor. So if your stepper motor won't move but the other works, maybe this fuse is blown. I think this fuse mostly blown because the full bridge MOSFET inside stepper motor controller is shorted. So you need check stepper motor controller first. This little tiny fuse is for 5 volt buck converter and it's not resettable fuse. The rating is crazy. 20 amps or 2 amps, it's not clear. This fuse will open when overloaded by 5 volt rail. It can happen maybe because 5 volt buck converter controller itself, diode, and capacitor fail. LCD display value can blow this fuse too. This 3.3 LVDO and the capacitor value can be a problem. Stepper motor controller have input from 5 volt too. Can be open this fuse. You need check continuity or inject voltage to check short circuit. Failure to this fuse will shut down majority component on this mainboard and LCD display, except the fan. Less 0 ohm resistor act like fuse for all fan. If all of your fan not turn on, this fuse may be open. You can easily jumper positive 24 volt header to always on fan header, because this fuse is hard to reach. The heated bed and the hot end doesn't have fuse, just rely on power supply hiccup over current protection and power supply fuse if soft protection failure. You can jumper all fuse if they open. At the end, power supply itself will protect from overload. The power supply normally will hiccup, or if soft protection failure, the fuse on the power supply will blow. Nothing to worry. PCB and soldering are good, but heatsink placement is super dodgy. Component placing is not very good compared to old model mainboard. They don't understand how to placing heatsink with thermal glue. You need to press it and make sure perfectly horizontal touching the chip below. Some component like MOSFET, I can check for the rating, but I never had problem. Let's talk about other component. Start from 5 volt buck converter, they use an firmware chip, not like the old mainboard. The buck converter itself still using diode. I hope they using synchronous buck converter, because today is already cheaper. For supplying 3.3 volt, like for microcontroller, they use famous LDO regulator IMS1116. For microcontroller, they use 32-bit RM Cortex M1 by STM32F1. It's have more gpio pin than old mainboard. For USB connection, STM32F103 needs serial to USB converter, because they don't have native USB connection. They use famous CH340. All stepper motor driver using silence TMC2208, but I can check. They have one chip HCT245, I don't know for what, because the track goes somewhere and placing in the middle far from anything. But I think for signaling between microcontroller and the microSD like the old mainboard. If you have open circuit at stepper motor controller, you need to check this all resistor. And don't forget to check all those diode and capacitor for short circuit. For the Vref, you need to adjust x-axis at about 1.1 volts, w-axis about 0.9 volts, z-axis about 1.1 volts, and the last extruder about 1.3 volts. Track for supply 24 volt stepper motor more better on this mainboard. They have built touch and additional pin for one more sensor like filament runout sensor. Last, they have one power LED status here and one communication status LED here. As I know, it will flashing when microcontroller communicate with microcontroller in LCD display. Now, microcontroller not driving directly to LCD. The LCD have all microcontroller. Idle power consumption is higher than old mainboard at 7 mV. Old mainboard only 2 mV. Okay, thank you everyone for watching. I hope you learned something new from this. If you have question, you can drop comment below. Follow my social media and visit my website for something interesting. Bye.